गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। और टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द टॉपिक द कास्ट सिस्टम एज अ डिस्क्रिमिनेटरी सिस्टम। स्टूडेंट, बिफोर दैट दिस वी हैव स्टडी द अबाउट द डिस्क्रिमिनेशन or exist discrimination which exists in our Indian society, stereotype behavior, stereotype discriminations and prejudices, which are the main just trauma or stigma of our society. We know stigma of our society, we have seen that how these are the stigma of today. The particular focus we shall see give on the caste system. I have not to say much about the caste system, that this caste system exists from our Varna Vyavastha, yeah, Varna system, from the ancient time. And through the Varna system, the four major castes, through the Varna system, through the on the macro level, the four major division of the caste has been made, like the Rajputs, Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and the Sudras, the four categorized. And from that many of the other branches of the jatis now expanded on the basis of the occupation. Students, now, on the basis of occupation, we have seen that the occupational base, the jatis, now jatis originated. So the thousands of hundreds of the occupations we have, so the hundred and thousands of the jatis now originated from these from the occupational base. So the major on the basis of major the construction of the caste structure, we have to see that Varna system, which includes the four major caste, and there are so many thousands of the sub caste here. The students, caste system we know very well, ki jo distinct Indian social institution. Caste, what is the caste? It is a social institution which has been evolved through the thousands of years, evolved over the time, and it is the just a institution, and this institution, caste system, is just as an institution which legalizes and enforces, which legalizes, enforces of indiscrimination against people born into a particular caste. What this caste system? The caste system is an institution which legalizes and enforces practices of discrimination. What the discrimination is being practiced in our society, that is legalized by the caste institution, which is legalized by the caste institution, or against those people who born in a particular caste. Understand that this is an caste system is an institution which legalizes and enforces the discrimination against those people, understand, who born in a particular caste. Understand? So this is the caste system, okay, or the caste discrimination we are studying. Moreover, or the practices which are enforced, the caste practices, the discrimination based on the caste practices. now reflect in the different forms. First, its reflection is in the form of discrimination. Second, humiliation. And next, exclusion and exploitation. These are the four factors which are the features of our caste discrimination. Discrimination, humiliation, certain castes are humiliated, certain castes are the excluded from the society. I have already taught the exclusion and exploitation, massive exploitation. So this system now, an institution and a caste institution which creates the four just a stigma and trauma of our society, in which a structural discrimination, humiliation, exclusion and the exploitation. Now, if you see from the historical point of view, if you go back, this system means caste system classified the people. What the caste system do? The caste system classified the people by their occupation and status. By their occupation and status, each one was associated with an occupation. Occupation and status. Understand how the people acquire this occupation and the status according to the caste institution, according to the caste system. A person acquires the institution and the status. Person born into the particular caste, they were also born into the particular occupation. Occupation was given according to the caste. The person, if the born particular caste, the particular occupation was given to him. And he had to be the worker associated with their caste. And they had no choice. And one features of this occupational caste, occupation acquired by the caste, had the features, there is no choice. And people had no choice of their own occupation. They could not have any choice of their occupation. And moreover, each caste also had a specific place. Each and every caste had its specific place in a caste hierarchy. We know very well, caste hierarchy. Now, in the caste hierarchy, we have studied in class 11, the caste hierarchy. This is the caste hierarchy. So everyone gets the status and occupation. Occupation and status. Occupation and status. That is the hierarchy. According to hierarchy, this is also called as the scribed status. Scribed status gets the. Now, here we happen to see they had no choice. Each caste had its specific place. Every caste has its specific place. Hierarchy in a social status, and also ranking within each the broad occupation, or in this Broad occupation, every caste had its ranking, Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudras and other sub-caste. Other jatis, whose born on the basis of occupation acquired. On the basis of new occupation, as the new occupation originate the new caste, or just holding that occupation, the new caste bonds. So now they got and ranking within broad occupation categories ranked by the social status. And these categories of the occupation, categories of the A, categories of occupation, understand? They got from the caste hierarchy. Understand? Brahman, simple. Take the example simply. Brahman, the worship. Acquired the education, impart the education. Kshatriyas, acquire and Kshatriyas now defend the country. A Vaishya class, producing and trading, cultivation. And the Shudra class, service. So similarly, the many caste, sub-caste, now born according to their they got the status according to their categories and their ranks. But there could be a further ranking within each broad occupational category. I have already mentioned that we can have the further category or the ranking. Now, in the Brahmins, Dube, Trivedi, understand? Chaturvedi, like that many of the categories are within the Brahmins. Kshatriyas, a lots of Kshatriya clans are now described in the history. Like the Vaishyas, now farmers, traders having the different caste jatis. And Shudras, among them, there are the many jatis and many categories. So this is the further ranking of the categories, occupational, broad occupational categories, and moreover, a strict scriptural terms. Now we know Dharma Shastra, society, the caste, the practices, status, were written down in the scriptures. So strictly these scriptures, scriptural terms, social and economic status were supposed to be sharply separated. Social and economic status was also sharply separated, or more of, as an example, now one thing was that very clear, now to ritual, highest caste Brahmins were associated with the performing the rituals and not supposed to be the amidst the wealth. Not supposed to be the. Our Dharma Shastra speaks that a Brahman should not amass the wealth. This is not the duty of a Brahman. Amass the wealth. And other hand, and these Brahmins were subordinated to secular power of the kings. Brahmins were subordinated under the secular power of the king, and where moreover the rulers belong to the Kshatriya caste. Generally, this Dharma Shastra speaks that the rulers should belong to the Kshatriya caste. On the other hand, despite having highest secular status, the power of king was subordinate to the Brahmins in the rituals and the religious spheres. How? We know that even the power of the king was restricted by the Kshatras and the Danda, scepter. Now on his backs, during the conscriptions, a Kshatras canopy, a danda from his back was not touched. and it was a mark that he is not beyond that. There is a dandi is punishment is for him also if he violates the rules of the and his duty. And this dandi is the now marked by the Brahman. Understand? This is the mark by the Brahmanas. So we can have each caste had its specific care and the danda. So we can see the king was subordinated Brahmana ritual religious spheres. However, in actual historical practices, economic and social status tended to coincide. Economic and social status is the tended to coincide each others. Understand? Having the highest status by the passage of the time. High status means the having the economic strength, economic gatherings, a fairly correlations between the social caste and status. Economic status, higher caste means the high economic status. Now later on, higher caste means the high economic status, lower caste means that the low economic status. So now here we can see that, but since the in the modern times, now the link between caste and occupation has become the much less rigid, much less. Now we know that because of the many of the changes happened in the modern times, and because of that, because of this, many of the changes came about and the caste rigidity had loosened. Caste rigidity or inflexibility loosened, because not less much rigid. Caste system is now not much less rigid. Rituals or religion prohibits on a occupational change. Not easy to impose today the new now occupation. Today, because of a religious prohibition has been the change now. Before the present time, it was enforced upon the particular caste group to occupy and to follow his own occupation. But now it is not forced. And now it is constitutionally prohibited. We know that in the constitution, many of the provisions has been laid down in the constitution. And moreover, not easily today, now occupational, caste and economic status correlation is also weaker. Caste and economic status correlation is also weaker. Now, it is not mean that a person belonging to the lower caste will be the poor and the weaker. No, this is the crisscross had become. Even the lower caste are the rich and the higher class is the poor. If within the lower caste, there are some very rich, and within the higher caste, there some are the very poor. So this rigidity of the caste has been the now this having the ended, and the, it is the losing. But and this is the now lay points. How this happens? How this happens? Because of that, because of spread of English education after the independence. Understand? The English education now influenced the Western ideas, because after the introduction of English education, this caste rigidity loosened. This society became more dynamic and moreover, the Western ideas spread and bring about the new ideas in the look, and conservative ideas begin to be the common. Moreover, Western ideas also values such as in Western ideas from the French Revolution, equality, liberty, and fraternity came, and that notion was now realized and experienced and prioritized by the Indians also. So under this independent notion, or under this free notion, and the notion of freedom and notion of the liberty, this caste system became the, and moreover, democracy, we, our Bharat, our India, adopted the democratic form of the government. And in the democratic form, everyone was made equal. Everyone had the equal rights. So the caste dominancy now gone away, and the weakening very fastly. Rationalism also now argument. Why I should and why you should. Why you should, why I should. Okay, so this rational and argument also in the caste system. Moreover, individualism, after the coming of the capitalism in India, by the British, they brought the capitalism in India and all over the world. So this individual notions also lose women's liberation, or that also lose secular ideas of secularism. This lose the caste system and humanitarianism, not to be the torture the lower caste like that on the basis of humanitarianism. These ideas and notion now is spread in our country, all over the, and losing these ideas. These ideas had deeply influenced the Western education, educated Indians. These ideas, no doubt, losing, influenced the Western education in India. Sufferers, large number of these sufferers, those who were the now victims of the caste system and caste atrocities, now they protested against the deprivation, exploitation and humiliation began to the, that way the caste systems, the traditional caste systems was destroyed, and it was losing or influence. Moreover, as the industrial revolutions came, people of the different castes rugged their soldier each others without the, regardless of their caste. So this is the also decline of caste based occupation system, and the Brahmins are the caste system. Impact of the urbanization also. Now urbanization, fast growing urban centers where the caste does not mean and have no meaning there, or little meaning there. Decline of caste-based occupational system. It means that caste mobility, occupational mobility came. Even the Brahmins adopt the different kinds of the profession and occupation for profit or interest. The Sudras and Vaishyas, they also adopt the different jobs and the different. So this had been the brought about the, and now moreover, influence the industrial impact of the urbanization. Lessen the dominance of the Brahmins. Because of the urbanization, Brahmins' dominancy was just gone. Brahmins. And moreover, changes in the traditional features of caste. Now, traditional features of caste that changed, begin to be the change now. And a religious basis of caste attack. Many of the religious basis of caste was attacked by the many scholars or the reformers, social or social religious reformers. They strike hard, struck hard upon the existing caste system. That's why the caste system was loosened because of that. And food restriction now relaxed. We don't care who is serving and who is sitting beside us in the restaurant. We don't care about that. So this food restriction also relaxed. Hereditary occupational mobility came. Now one is not bound to having just adopt its own occupation of their forefathers. It is not the compulsory and binding. Moreover, changes in the role of caste system, increase in organizational power of caste, because now many of the organization are being, many organizations are being made or being organized and fought against the caste system. And the caste power, the different lower caste are polarizing. Dalit are coming together politically. Backwards are coming together and polarizing together and politically becoming the stronger. And they are now seeking their voice in the legislation or in the assemblies. So we can see that, and the protection of the ST and or the backward classes, many laws have been enacted by in our constitution or by the government for the protection and the, from the atrocities and the discrimination on the basis of caste. Understand? So the caste system is a illusion, and it is the, and by the government, backward caste movement is rampant. Backwards caste, they organized and launched the movement against the caste system and against that. So we see that this caste system is prevalent all over the still, but what is this? This is the still in the now key point. Caste system is still existing in our society. First, class for still remarkable, stable in its macro level. As we agar hum dekhen, if you see that, this is the rampant on the macro level. First, as the system has become less rigid, system of the caste system had become the less rigid, social and economic status have the weakened, no doubt. But differences exist in the grouping and our society. Still, despite these all, yet this is the existing in our society. Differences exist. High caste, high economic status is still, if you observe, or if you just make the survey like that, they still high caste are the dominating in the social structure. Lower caste having the low economic status, and this can be the proved by the survey methods. And proportion of the population that lives in poverty. The large proportion of the population lives in poverty. Large proportion still, we see the large proportion are bound to live in the poverty. Poverty still, or affluence differs greatly across the caste groups. Those who are the affluent, those who are the well-to-do, well-off, they now are the different, a great different, living with a great difference across the caste groups. You can see, you can observe, even present day in the 21st century, even they are the still upper caste dominates the lower caste. It is the fact of our society. Still, if you see, the upper caste are the very much dominating over. And next, we have to be the, even though there have been the major change brought about by the social movement, still a major change has been the brought about by the social movement. Social movement by the Rajaram Mohan Roy, now the Justice Ranade, or by the and Swami Dayanand Saraswati, Vivekanand, and Jyotiba Rao Phule, Naikar, or any patient, these all the social reformers now made the effort for the end of the caste system. With their efforts, the caste system and many of the caste disability act was now enacted. I have already mentioned that now in 1850, the caste Disability Act removed. It was against the caste practice of untouchability. Although this has been made the part of the Indian Constitution, that no caste will be there will be no untouchability. Untouchability was made the punishable. If somebody try to practice this untouchability, that person will be liable for the punishment by the law. Understand? So this has been done. Even in 1872, the Special Marriage Act was passed. Legalized the inter-caste marriage. This was all breaking the caste system. Inter-caste marriage or even the inter-religious marriage was allowed. Even 1872 by the law. By Special Marriage Act, 1872. And now, moreover, the Hindu Widow Remarriage Act, 1856. This allowed the legal permission given to the remarried to the widows. Understand? Widows. So we see that the caste system is just prevalent in our society. Even then, many of the laws passed, but the only law will not serve a lot. Without law is not much for that. If you want to be remove the caste system, we should be very aware. We can't bring the change by the law, but we can bring the change by the heart. This is required of the heart and thinking. Through this, even though we should see that, even though there have been the major changes brought about by the social movements over the more than a century. Although these movements now, the Dayanam Satya Sodhak Samaj, Naikar, and the Narayan Guru, these reformers have made the strike upon the caste system. But they had been brought about a good consequences and the good result, and the far extent the laxity of the caste system had come in our society. But despite these, mode of production as well concerted attempts by the state to suppress its public role, caste system has been completely suppressed in the public role. In the independent India, caste continues to affect life of chances of the Indians in the 21st century. Still, the life chances have affected by the caste system in the 21st century also. So, student, the caste system, what is the discrimination on the basis of the caste system, how the caste system have been eradicated, how it was influenced, understand, or how it is being eradicated, or being eradicated, or loosening, and the flexibility is coming, and moreover, the impact of the upon the caste system, the industry is modernizing. Industries, hotel, motel, all these things, development, railway, bus, transportations, or industries, or the Western ideas, impact of Western ideas, these all things, and the modern democracy established in our country are the factors of the removing the caste system in India. But still, in fact, what do we know? There is no change in the caste. A very little bit impact of the institution of caste had been. Otherwise, untouchability has been diminishing, but caste system is not diminished. It is still existing, and how long this will exist, let's see the coming ages. Thank you very much.